Will democracy survive the next couple of years?
And essentially, we are the same.
Can't have government choosing winners or losers.
There are so many needs that Minnesota has.
What people are saying they need right now.
Access to Democracy is made possible in part by a donation from Firefly Credit Union. Firefly is the new name of U.S. Federal Credit Union, which has proudly served the financial needs of the greater Twin Cities community since 1925. At Firefly, we guide our members forward and give them the power to chase dreams by delivering the financial solutions they need to get ahead. From checking accounts to mortgages, we'll light the way. We are Firefly Credit Union, and this is Life Illuminated. And Dr. Charles Crutchfield of award-winning Crutchfield Dermatology in Eagan, acknowledged as one of the nation's best physicians, a Minnesota native who trained at the Mayo Clinic, Dr. Crutchfield personally treats all patients and states that experience counts and quality matters. Crutchfield Dermatology, look good, feel great, with beautiful skin.
Democracy Returns, one of our favorite guests, also one of our benefactors, Dr. Charles Crutchfield, whose reputation precedes him, certainly recognized as one of the not only best dermatologists, but best doctors in the country. As you walk through his office, there are more awards there than really room to room to room, different awards that he has won. I don't know how you have done all that and accomplished everything that you have done.
Well, thank you for those kind words. You know, I tell people it happens with time, but it means I'm just getting older. I'm a little bit older, so thank you so much. It's a delight to be here, as always.
Well, we've had you on one show with your dad, who is a doctor as well. Your father and mother, both physicians.
Yep, they went to medical school together, attended the University of Minnesota Medical School back in the early 60s, graduated in 63, and as you and I have talked about, Mom was the first African-American female to graduate from the University of Minnesota Medical School. But as she says, her pride was she was also the very youngest to graduate, at age 22, to graduate from medical school.
So that That's was quite amazing. A
And Dad was right behind her. He was 23, and he's Dad has delivered over 10,000
over 10,000
in the Twin Cities
births. So, yeah. Right, that's
a, so they made it easy for me to practice medicine.
And we've also had daughter Olivia on several occasions, who has so many talents that we will take up half the show talking about them. But she is now a freshman at NYU.
At the Stern School of Business there, and she's very loquacious, and I think she gets that from her grandfather.
You think so?
Yeah, I think so. Well, she started a couple weeks ago, and she's having a great time. She's right in Greenwich Village, right at the school there, and she's got five roommates, so they're having a nice time.
Five roommates, but who share one bathroom.
That's right.
I don't know.
I don't know. I said, you better get a schedule.
How any six women can share one bathroom.
So I said, well, it's working, but yeah, it's a challenge.
But that's really great. Yeah. And she's such a talented young woman.
Well, thank you.
In terms of her art and her photography, and what can I say?
Yeah. It's a,
we'll have her on when she's back.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah, that's a, and now, you're so involved in so many projects, and I know you can't talk about physician-patient situations, but you had a patient by the name of Hap. And I think that maybe Hap will not object if we discuss the situation with Hap.
Yes.
So tell us about Hap.
We got a call from the Minnesota Zoo this summer, and they said, do you do Botox? And I said, well, yes, I do. And they said, have you ever done Botox on a shark? And I said, no, I haven't. And they said, would you be willing to try to do Botox or help us with Botox on a shark? And I thought about it, and I thought, why not? Mm-hmm. And so they have a shark there, a sand shark called Haps. And Haps is well known and loved by many visitors. But Haps has a condition called scoliosis. And scoliosis is a curvature of the spine. And scoliosis happens in all animals and humans. And it can be caused by several things. But this particular case, of curvature of the spine and Haps the shark was due to a unilateral one-sided muscular contraction. So Haps kind of had a mild C shape. And this happens to all sharks, but it also happens to sharks in captivity. And so they were really worried about Haps, and I was so impressed with the caring attitude and how gentle and concerned all the people at the zoo are for the animals that they're the caretakers for. So we decided we'd give it a try. It's only been done one other time in the world, and it was done by a veterinarian in Australia.
I was going to say that was the Australia situation, yeah.
And so I guess the veterinarians, they know each other well, and so the veterinarians at the Minnesota Zoo communicated with this veterinarian, and so we got all the parameters and the amounts and everything, so we decided to give Haps a Botox injection. So I worked with the veterinarian at the zoo, Dr. Rachel Thompson, and so we planned it all out. I did all the dilutions for her. We plotted it out, and I showed her exactly where to inject, and she did the injections with me right by her side, and they said first, you can get in the water with Haps the shark, but we need to get you a wetsuit. And I said, well, that's not going to happen, so we'll work on the side of the pool. And we did have some. The thing about sharks is their metabolism is slow. In humans, when you inject Botox, it can work in about a week. But in sharks, it can take 2 to 4 weeks. And so just a few weeks ago, or about a month out, we heard that Haps is doing much, much better. And we're in discussions that we might end up doing another treatment in the not-too-distant future. So we were so happy to help Haps the shark out. The first shark in the United States ever had Botox to treat this condition that's really a problem for many sharks in captivity.
And the first dermatologist in the United States who has treated a shark.
Yes.
But you know what I heard?
Mm-hmm.
I heard that there are a lot of older lawyers who heard that you are treating sharks now. And they're going to line up to get scoliosis treated.
Well, I tell you, the next day, this is the funniest thing. I've never been asked this in my whole career. The next day in clinic, a woman came in. She was in for some other things. She said, I have mild scoliosis of the back. Have you ever used Botox to treat scoliosis? And the day, I said, only in sharks, because the day before I treated a shark. So. Anyway, congratulations to Minnesota Zoo for really going the extra mile for one of the animals they're taking care of, and we were happy to participate.
And it's so typical of you, though, as to be ready at any given moment to go the step beyond the cutting edge and get into something new. Now, one of the things I wanted to talk about also is that you set up the Crutchfield Foundation a while back.
Yes.
And the Crutchfield Foundation has been involved in a lot of civic and charitable endeavors.
Yes.
But you have one coming up on the 29th of September here in 2018.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll bring up in a moment, we'll bring up a picture of it. But it's directed toward escalating teenage suicides and how to prevent them.
Exactly.
Now, how did you get involved with that?
Well, you know, we try to bring up timely topics through the Crutchfield Dermatology Foundation, and last year we did distracted driving because that's such a problem. You know, there are between 10 and 15 deaths every day in the United States as a result directly from distracted driving. And this year we're focusing on suicide prevention because it's a subject that's so near and dear to so many people's hearts.
Rita, if you can bring that up now.
There's probably not a family in the United States where suicide hasn't touched them in some way. And we lost a dear family member. I lost a cousin to suicide a couple years ago. And so we wanted to bring this up and do this as a public service and to talk about awareness and do suicide prevention.
So this is the side of Crutchfield Dermatology, or Crutchfield, Charles Crutchfield III, that people don't know about. And as we're looking at this, it's the 29th of September
2018.
And where is it going to be?
It's going to be at the Best Western Dakota, which is right in the heart of Eagan, close to 35 and right off Yankee Doodle Road. So it's 11:30 to 12. It's just an hour-long presentation. There'll be refreshments coming up on Saturday, the 29th of September this year, on suicide prevention.
Teenage suicide is such a problem, but the fact is that you have recognized it and you have devoted your funds and your foundation to at least trying to help the problem.
Yes.
And we're not going to solve the problem, but if we can stop one suicide.
We want to chip away at it because it's devastating and it affects so many people.
And That's just one of many, many endeavors that you're in. I mean, if you walk through Crutchfield Dermatology Office, number one, there is Dr. Crutchfield, and then there are about 40 people, assistants with different degrees, medical degrees, and nurses and things like that. And all these rooms, this is to say nothing of the cosmetic end of it, but there's only one doctor, and that's you. And you managed, and I don't know how you do it, because you can walk into the waiting room and there'll be 20 people sitting there. You manage to be the one person who treats every medical case.
Correct. And that was one of the things, our goals years ago, to set it up, because we wanted to have a new medical model where the support staff actually support the physician, and the physician still sees every patient. In this day and age, there are a lot of situations where patients go to clinics and they never see the doctor. They all see some support staff. But at our clinic, the patients always see the physician, and the physician is supported heavily by the support staff. So it's really a neat system that works. And I think if we use this in more places, I think the healthcare in the United States would be a lot better.
And it certainly works for you, and it certainly is unique, and it certainly is amazing. Then you have the cosmetic side of the industry, where you, as a former biologist, have created a lot of the materials which are used. You know, you walk into some of these stores and you see women's products that are outrageously priced, but you have formulated a lot of these on your own, and you make them available to your patients.
Yes, and we do it at a cost-effective manner. And the nice thing is there are different compounding laws that allow prescriptions to develop and provide products to their patients, not on a broad scale, but to their patients. And we do that in our office, and we try to do things where it's cost effective, probably less than a copay in most cases. So it's convenient for the patients, because you think about it, it's a very strange system where you go to one place and they say, you've got this, and they scribble something on a piece of paper, and then you have to drive somewhere else, you have to give that paper to someone else, and then they give. So it's very strange. So we want to just make it a one-stop shop. Come, get it, go home, and you're taken care of.
I don't know how you function without sleep, because you're involved in so many things that you can't sleep. There's no
way. I sleep a lot. My son says I tend to do it when I watch the Twins baseball games at home. And I tell him I'm just resting my eyes. And he said, Dad, then why do you snore when you rest your eyes?
I use that technique also. And Sharon says, no, you were asleep. And I said, no, I was just resting my eyes.
No, I've got great family support and great staff at work. Without them, it wouldn't work. So, yeah, we try to build a great team.
However, you were spotted at a Twins game just a couple days ago with your eyes open when they were playing the Yankees.
That's right. I went to all the Yankees games, and I saw Joe Mauer hit his grand slam home run, so that was a ball. That was a treat. I took my son there for his 15th birthday.
Well, good for him.
Yeah.
And you have three children?
Yep, Olivia and then Charles, who's 15 at St. Thomas. He's a freshman at St. Thomas Academy, and then I have Ariana, who's at Black Hawk Middle School. She just started this year. So. And we also went with my friend David Ellis, who's been on the show, and he runs High School for Recording Arts, which is a school for at-risk youth.
Yeah, David's been here at least once, possibly twice.
Yes.
And talked about the unusual things that they do, but now you tell me that there's something new that the High School for Recording Arts is, and we're going to have to get him back to talk about it, but why don't you tell us a little bit about it?
Briefly, what they're trying to do is fill the gap. They're trying to fill the gap for McNally, which is a music school college that closed in St. Paul. And so they've got a lot of students that are graduating that are interested in music and music production and the business end of music, but there's not an official place to go. So they're trying to create a program where they can go and attend and get a certificate. Eventually they're going to develop it into an associate's program. But the nice thing is they're developing a program where the students can attend it at either low cost, or if you're a graduate of the High School of Recording Arts, you can attend it tuition free. So when you complete the certificate course, you can go out and get a job in the industry. And unlike other colleges like McNally, you don't have this huge debt load when you're finished. So it's a great program. Once again, Crutchfield Dermatology Foundation is helping to sponsor it. And we actually just gave a donation in the honor of a guy by the name of George Morifetis, a good Greek guy. He was one of my good friends in college who passed away not too long ago. So we gave a scholarship in his name to get the Center for Media Diversity up and running. So that's going to be coming hopefully in the next year with them, and we get David on the show and talk about it. But it's a great thing for students at risk and students in St. Paul.
And as long as we're talking about people who I have met through you who have been on the show, we have the Black Community Project,
yes,
which you're very involved,
yes,
in. The foundation is, you are individually, your family is, and that's coming to fruition in not too long a time.
Yes, we're wrapping it up right now, and hopefully we're going to have a release for Black History Month in February of 2019. But it comes from an amazing project by where a gentleman all by himself, Anthony Scott, he made a book, and it featured African-Americans across the Twin Cities in all walks of life. You know, it could be barbers, hairdressers, politicians, religious leaders, sports people, attorneys, and he featured them in his book. And
we had some excerpts from,
yes,
it, yes, on the show.
Yeah, so he did the original one in around 1960 called The Beacon, the Minneapolis or the Twin Cities Beacon. Then he did another edition around 1970, and then he did another edition around 1980. So three of these editions, and when you look back, when you open this book, it's a treasure trove of people who've made great contributions to the Twin Cities community as African Americans. And it's turned out to be, there's nothing else like it, and we're so lucky to have it because it documents all of the great citizens of the Twin Cities in Minnesota that have done great things for our community. And so we talked to the family, and his three sons and his daughter, they're still alive, and we said, let's revive it. And so they said, absolutely. So they, you know, Shonda, who's his daughter, she's kind of taken the mantle and run with it. We're all helping out, and so we've got another edition coming out 40 years after the last edition, featuring great citizens of Minnesota and the African-American community and things they're doing. So we're really looking forward to it.
And I'm pretty certain that there's going to be a couple of Crutchfields who are among the people that are featured.
Yes, and you know, the nice thing was back in the earlier edition, Mom and Dad were featured. They were young African-American physicians, and they also had my grandmother, who was the first African-American school teacher in Minneapolis. And so she's featured, and she had an interesting story. She applied to become a teacher in Minneapolis from West Virginia, and the school board accepted her application. And when she moved here and they saw her,
shock,
they said, excuse us, never mind. They withdrew the job offer. And at the time, there was a newspaper publisher, Newman, and he said, we're going to bring this to light and talk about this. But even more so, there was a mayor of Minneapolis who got wind of it. His name was Hubert Humphrey.
Fellow we've heard of, yes.
And so Hubert Humphrey went to the school board and said, either re-offer her the position or the city, we're going to file suit. And the school board backed down. And that was thanks to Hubert Humphrey and Newman of the Black newspaper at the time standing up for her. And she became the first Black teacher.
Minneapolis, in some respects, doesn't have an unsullied reputation when it comes to prejudice. And even today, there is a project right now going into deeds. So many deeds have covenants in them that restrict people from selling to both Black and Jews. And it's
amazing in this day and age that something like that would still exist.
Well, the thing is that the covenants don't go away. The deed doesn't go away, but there was a law passed that made it illegal to do that. And that's a very interesting project that we had a seminar on,
yeah,
at some point. And they're working section by section. There were
good
other minorities besides Blacks,
right,
and
right,
Jews.
Right.
But right in the deed, it says you may not convey ever. Well, ever is not as long as ever seems to be, because it was made illegal,
yeah,
as well it should.
As it should.
And of course, the city are reasonably integrated, not integrated enough.
Mm-hmm.
And we still have areas of abject poverty. And mm-hmm. what happens when you have abject poverty, you have crime.
Right.
And that's something that we all have to work at and mm-hmm. hope.
Well, the key is constant improvement. You know, there's always trying to get better.
We have to have acceptance by people that color is really meaningless.
Mm-hmm.
It's not color. It's what's inside of somebody. We mentioned as we were going on the air, we have a new police chief here
mm-hmm.
in Eagan, Roger New. He is really new.
He's really new. I had dinner with him last week. He's a great guy. Fantastic.
A terrific cop, a terrific person, trained by a terrific policeman, Jim McDonald.
Yes.
And Roger will be a guest on Access in a few weeks, as a matter of fact.
I'll be watching.
And, yeah. But here's the first police chief of color in this community. And would that we had less Charlottesvilles and more acceptance of people for who and what they are. And I know that's one of the things that you work on in the foundation as well.
Yeah, through that.
Another thing you do is you will sponsor forums for primarily, I guess, women. Well, you'll have wine and cheese and sandwiches and demonstrations of various products, many of which you give away. And I understand there's music.
Sometimes,
I understand there's an artist there who teaches people to paint.
Yeah.
And
we decided we want to go the extra mile and really say thank you to a lot of our patients, especially in the aesthetic medical and aesthetic dermatology. That are really ambassadors for our practice. But we talk about new products and we try to make it in a really fun, friendly, relaxed atmosphere. And we should do that quarterly for a lot of our patients. We send out newsletters and talk about it. And we usually have a really nice turnout.
And I understand it's very enjoyable.
Good, good.
I have that on good information.
Excellent.
Now, you know that I had a tough physical year last year. And in fact, I went about last December, the end of last December, to the Mayo Clinic, weighing 140 pounds. And I didn't know what was around the corner. Well, not only did we find out what the problem was, a misdiagnosis from 6 years earlier, but as a bonus, we found out that I had a malignancy on my thyroid. So not necessarily the kind of bonus that you look forward to. But
Those things better to catch early, sooner than later.
In May, Dr. Thompson, who's been a guest here recently, with photos of my operation.
How about that?
And really is the chief endocrinologist in terms of surgery there. Worked on it. You can't even see the scar. And did a wonderful job. And I'm on my way back for the follow-up exams in a couple of months. But the Mayo is such a unique institution.
It is.
You were a part of it, and you are still a part of it. And I have, on several occasions, said I just can't say enough about the expertise, the professionalism, the attitude of everybody at the Mayo Clinic. It was just recently selected as the number one hospital again in the country, with six specialties that are number one. Well-deserved.
I feel fortunate because they had a good program when I was an undergrad. I went to Carleton College in Northfield, and so as an undergrad, I did a summer internship there. So that's why it was my introduction to the Mayo Clinic. I worked in a research laboratory, and now I teach at Carleton College too part-time. I'm a biology professor there, spring term. But I feel so fortunate because I had my, I did my medical school at the Mayo Clinic, which is an amazing institution, and I did my residency at the University of Minnesota. In Minnesota, we are so lucky. We have so many great medical institutions right here in our backyard. In fact,
no question.
Yeah, so between those two, I was so lucky. Although I did 1 year at the Gunderson Clinic, I did my internship year in Wisconsin. So I still cheered for the Vikings, but I was in Wisconsin for a year. And so we've got great medical institutions, including Mayo. And it's my understanding that Ken Burns is doing a documentary.
Yeah, it'll be out later this month also.
Yeah.
On the Mayo Clinic, which has very unique background and beginning with the two Mayo brothers.
Right.
Now, speaking of the Vikings, there is a Dr. Crutchfield who is the dermatologist of the Twins and also of the Minnesota Wild, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct.
And matter of fact, your first interview when you were scheduled here got canceled at the last minute because you had to hop a plane and go to Fort
Florida.
Myers.
That's
because
right.
somebody was having a skin problem in spring training with the
That's
Twins.
That's right. That's right. Yeah.
And
it's kind of nice because it's Blossom, and we also treat the Timberwolves and the Vikings now. So we kind of help out wherever we can, whatever we need, we help out.
Well, the Vikings are now neighbors of ours.
Mm-hmm. Right, it makes it much more convenient. We see them even more now.
Yeah.
Because we're right next door.
And they like to complain, so the fact that they can go to the doctor.
Right.
It's great. It's just a unique life, a unique practice that you have put together. And obviously, you are a very creative person who has not only put it to use, but appreciated where you come from and the fact that you give back so much to the community.
Well, you know, the thing is, we've talked about this before. You know, I stand on the shoulders of giants. I wouldn't be where I'm at if it wasn't for all the work for the people before me. And the other thing, too, is all the people I work with, they support me so well. Without them, we couldn't do anything. I have to also give credit to my wife. She's our chief financial officer at our office, and she allows me to practice medicine, so I don't have to worry about all the other, the business end. She takes care of that. So.
Does she give you an allowance?
Yeah, she does.
Oh, okay.
Of course. So, yeah. So I give them all credit, and it really makes everything work.
Well, what can I say? As a patient, as a benefactor, as a friend, you are a unique human being.
Thank you so much.
Having had the opportunity to have you come into my life has made a big difference with me and my family. So
I'm always happy to help. And so that's one of the other things too that we really worked on hard this year. There's a thing called Camp Discovery, and Camp Discovery is a camp for children with skin disorders. And that was one of the funnest things I did as a, growing up, was going to camp.
That's through the foundation also, though, Camp Discovery.
Yes. And so, but I used to go to camp. But if you're a child with skin disease, you might have vitiligo or eczema, you don't want to take your shirt off. You don't want to go swimming because you're embarrassed about the way your skin looks. Well, at this camp, and it was first devised by Dr. Mark Dahl, who's the chairman at the University of Minnesota Dermatology Department when I went there, it's a camp for kids with all skin. So you go there and no one cares because everybody has skin problems, so that melts away. So we sponsor, and all the campers attend free. They fly them there. It's a great opportunity. So for kids with skin problems, it's a great summer camp to go to. In fact, most of the kids that go there, when they get too old to go there, they come back as counselors. So it's a wonderful thing where we've got several of our patients that we've sponsored and they go to the camp.
And I have to say, having been in the office on a number of occasions, that I ask every time, how long have you been with Crutchfield? And 11 years, 12 years, whatever it happens to be. Long-term employees, and I say, how do you like him? They say, we love him. He's such a good boss.
How nice.
What a nice person. And, you know, unique, unusual to have that overwhelming effervescence by so many people, and you don't get many people in your lifetime that you can say that about. So
that's
whatever
so nice
you're
to
doing,
hear. Yeah.
You're
I'll
doing,
keep trying to do it because that's really nice.
You're
nice
doing many things right.
Thank you.
And we actually have run out of our half hour. So
I can't believe it. It feels like we just sat down.
Dr. Charles Crutchfield of Eagan, certainly
thank
highly
you for
recommended.
Having me. Once again,
thank you.
Love being on the show, and I look forward to it again in the future
Good.
Sometime.
Thanks again.